Hey, I'm Avalon. In this video, I'm gonna show you how tournaments in Clash Royale are won. You know, I hosted several tournaments and I gathered all that data and did some analysis, and I will give you the facts here. What decks and what cards are best in tournaments? In this video, there will be no guessing. I had a close look at all the decks that scored in the top 10 of my tournaments. I will give you the facts in this video, and I will give you the best decks depending on what cards you might have if you want to score in tournaments. First, I'm gonna give you the facts that I found in my tournaments, and second, I will show you the best decks from the tournaments. Fact number one, legendaries win tournaments. We always thought it, but it's proven in the data. 90% of all top 10 scoring decks had at least one legendary in it. But there is hope. 10% made it to the top 10 without any legendary in their decks. And I will show you the decks that made it to the top 10 without legendaries in this video. 40% had one legendary. 38% of top 10 scorers, two legendaries in their decks. And an amazing 12% of top 10 players had three legendary cards in their decks. Fact number two. We always suspected it, and the data says it's true. Miners win tournaments. 63% of top scoring decks contain the miner. Fact number three, and that may be a surprise, it's cheap decks that win tourneys. The average cost of decks in the top 10 in my tournaments was below 3.6 elixir cost. And the most expensive at 4.4, and the cheapest deck that is successful at 2.9 elixir. And this leads directly to fact number four. Why are miner decks so successful in tournaments? Because they are cheap. The average cost of miner decks is actually better than the average cost of all decks in the tournaments. They are below 3.5 elixir cost. Most of them actually at 2.9 or 3.0 elixir cost only. But enough of the facts. Now, based on these facts, let me show you what kind of decks are most successful, and let me show you what deck may be appropriate for you for tournaments depending on what cards you might have to choose from. If you want to play successful, those are the cheapest deck in tournaments with 2.9 elixir cost only. One of them contains Miner and Princess, and the other one contains the Elixir Pump. And these decks, only slightly more expensive, it's the Miner decks at 3.0 Elixir cost. Notice that these are all Miner decks that are that cheap. First, we have Miner Princess decks. They work extremely well in tournaments. The second combination you may want to use is Miner Wizard. And if you're having the luxury of actually having three legendary cards, Miner Princess Wizard, also possible at 3.0 elixir cost and also very successful in tournaments. And number four in this series of very successful and cheap Miner decks, if you only have the Miner and no other legendary, there is a Miner Balloon combination that was used in tournaments and is very successful as well. Notice how Lava Hound and Sparky do not play a role here in that area of most successful decks, and that's mainly because they make the decks more expensive. And as I said before, it's cheap decks that win tournaments. But just to be complete, there are Sparky decks that actually made it into the top 10 in tournaments, and those are the Sparky decks that made it. Notice how they have an elixir cost of 4.3. And there is also a Lava Hound deck with an elixir cost of 4.4. Notice, in all but one of these decks, there is also a miner. So as I said, the miner really dominating tournaments at the moment, and you're very lucky if you have a tournament. And you're really lucky if you have a miner at your hands. Now, what can you do if you don't have a miner? And maybe you have a Sparky and you can use the Sparky instead and try to be successful with the Sparky deck. The next very successful category of tournament decks are decks containing the Princess. The Princess, also a huge game changer, a very strong legendary card. And if you don't have the miner and have at least the Princess, there are many decks that you can use with the Princess that are really strong due to the Princess. They're cost usually about 4 elixir, and notice how all of them contain an elixir pump and a mini P.E.K.K.A. So, learning from experience, that's probably the way you should compose your Princess decks. Now, what if you only have an Ice Wizard as a legendary card? There are also very successful decks just containing the Ice Wizard. And all of those decks use Royal Giant. So if you only have the Ice Wizard to use and you want to be successful in tournaments, you may combine the Ice Wizard and the Royal Giant. That's probably your option to go if that's the case. And now, what do you do if you don't have any legendaries at all? It's possible. I told you before, 10% actually make it into the top 10 of tournaments without any legendaries. How do they do it? Between all those decks, the trifecta decks actually works best. And notice that it's the cheapest of those decks that made it into the top 10. So again, we have the relation here from cheap decks to being successful in tournaments. The cheaper, the better. So I hope this selection of decks gives you an idea on what is best suited for you to use in tournaments. Basically, it depends on how many legendaries you have at your hand and what legendaries you have. We've seen the miner is the most successful, so you're very lucky if you have the miner. If not, you may want to use Princess if you have that one, or you may go and use the Ice Wizard at least together with the Royal Giant. And if you have none of those, you still have a chance. The chance is smaller. But yeah, you can choose one of those decks, and I hope that makes you more successful in tournaments. I'm definitely gonna try some of those decks I found in my tournaments, and it's proven by my very small statistics, of course, that I did based on the data that I have available. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it helps you. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for more awesome videos. And also, please comment and like the video. And stay awesome! The host pays for the tournament, so give the host a chance to define what rules he wants established in that tournament. I would like to say what cards I want to allow in tournaments, and this opens up for a lot of fun tournaments, like an all-skeleton tournament or an only commons tournament. So special events like that, we can select the cards that should be used in those tournaments.